as you see these worlds, those of you who are film friendly, think of this as not just a first cut or a rough cut after the film was complete. Think of this as a first draft. And then you'll see how many fantastic steps we still have left to go between now and November when we go out there online with this. And
so. So now you can see how Steven is represented in cyberspace.
Yeah, I guess you could have called E.T. a self-portrait.
Now we've just entered the third of our three virtual environments here. This one, for obvious reasons, called Skyworld. And we can dance around amongst the clouds. So, yeah, just keep swinging to your left.
Okay, now we're going to talk to the bouncing ball. Hi, do you see me?
Hi.
So I see you the same way that you see me. This is and this is 400 miles away as we speak.
Yep. Hmm?
Yeah. Yeah, these children are at Lucile Packard Hospital in Stanford right now. Okay. Hi, Fish.
Hi.
And what's your name?
Vanessa.
Hi, I'm Steven, or E.T., as they call me sometimes. Okay, and where are you right now?
By the castle.
Okay. I'd love to see what you look like, what you really look like. Can I see you?
Yes.
And I'm going to go down to click down on the camera, and let's see what we can do. There we are. Every home should not be without one of these, I'm telling you right now. So tell me about yourself.
I'm 13, and I have osteosarcoma. I like swimming and play softball.
Okay, don't be shy. Just step up to the Intel camera. There we go. Hello.
This is my mom.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, how are you?
Hi. That's great.
By November, how many kids will we be accommodating, how many sites, and so forth? Lee?
Yes, we anticipate that
shows the promise of the head-mounted displays. And we're also working with some companies that have direct muscle twitch response devices.
There's the crystal.
Oh, he's going for the crystal.
Well, where is he?
You got to turn around.
I did.
That's very cool. I think you can change the colors.
This way. Where are you going?
And the ball just
landed
on you.
He teleported her on top of me.
Yeah.
Now where are you going, Megan?
I don't know.
Everybody can play together. That's something that's so mind-blowing with this idea, is that kids, while a prisoner of hospital technology, will be able to be freed under the blue skies of this technology. And it's going to be a way for, you know, hundreds of kids to play together every day, get to know each other, and then they can communicate beyond this. They can just pick up the telephone and call each other, become real good friends. And while Starbright defined the need for Starbright World, we would not be standing here today without the leadership, dedication, and most importantly, the vision of our corporate partners. Their gift to the Starbright World cannot be measured. They have come together to create a new technology, and they've generously given the crown jewel of their portfolios for the sole purpose of helping kids.
UB Networks is extremely excited to be part of this. We've worked hard to make these technologies available a little bit earlier maybe than from the business point of view, but we are here and we are connecting quite some very interesting environments, as you will see later on. Starbright World will provide a new and never done before environment in which the children will be empowered, they will be on their own, they can develop their own skill sets and their own imagination.
A good friend of mine at Knowledge Adventure, Roger Holzberg, said, we've met some people from Starbright who are thinking about combining technology and Hollywood and medical expertise to come up with something that would help kids who are stuck in hospitals and can't get out. At that precise moment, I knew what Worlds Incorporated's first mission would be.
We at Intel see this as a wonderful example of the human face of technology. There are real benefits that technology can have on our everyday lives for everyone. This is a natural partnership, kids and computers. And Starbright has gone that one better by bringing together very special children with very special computers and special software applications. For us, Starbright is a wonderful opportunity to do what we do best, technology, and to bring it to those who need it the most.
I can tell you that no single venture or technological breakthrough has more vividly driven home the potential of the information superhighway than Sprint's alliance with the Starbright Foundation. Starbright has touched our hearts. It has reminded us that the true value of technology is its ability to improve the quality of our lives.
As a mother, I can't think of a more worthwhile goal than helping hospitalized children out of their pain and isolation. So I was pleased to learn that my favorite communications company, Sprint, had linked up with the Starbright Foundation to help create Starbright World.